Okay, here we go. It's the Peak Designs Travel Tripod. I'm just gonna share my thoughts and opinions about it real quick. So, the first thing about it, in my opinion, this thing looks slick. It looks amazing. I think that's probably the best thing about it. It's really cool looking. It looks, you know, it looks expensive. And I do think if you're using this, like, as your main tripod on a set or something, or like I do real estate, I don't think anyone's gonna question it. You know what I mean? It looks high quality. But I will say mine, almost immediately these legs came loose and it would just collapse on itself, which not that big a deal, but I almost immediately lost this tool. Like the first trip I went on, this tool was gone because it just flies out so easy here. You know what I mean? It just comes out so easily and I lost it and it really, really sucked. But when you order another one, you still have your original little holder. You put it on top like that. It stays put. I haven't lost it since. So that was kind of annoying. This tripod was useless for about 2 weeks because I didn't have the tool. You can just get a regular Allen wrench. I could have fixed it that way, but I just wanted to wait for the actual tool just because I don't want to strip anything or use the wrong size Allen key, anything like that. So that kind of sucks. So just be aware of that. This thing you will probably lose. And I would recommend just buying it a spare right when you get this thing. So $350. This is the aluminum one. I would just stay away from the carbon fiber one. I don't think that's really worth it. I mean, if you got money to blow, I mean, that's your decision, I guess, buy it. But I think the aluminum is the one I would get, and that's the one I would recommend most people. You do get, it comes with, there's a little phone holder in here. So I think that something like this, you know, if you're a real estate agent, I do real estate photography, but if you're a real estate agent and you don't want to hire a photographer, this would probably be good because you could just use this, hook your phone up to it, and get some pretty stable shots that way. So that's kind of cool. I'm never going to use that, but somebody might. So, and you know, like I said, $350, you get the whole kit. You get the center column, you get the head. So you're pretty much ready to go. And I get that $350 is kind of a lot of money, you know, especially if you're still starting out. But my first tripod was like $100. So I think that this is probably better than a really cheap, you know, $100 tripod. It looks good. But and this is why I don't think $350 is that much, because you come over here, this tripod, you know, you're talking $400 just for the tripod. I think the center column was $150. The head's like $200. So like this is you're getting into like almost $800, I think, for this thing. This is quite the, and this tripod really isn't that expensive, because I know some people have like, I think like the really right stuff tripods, I think, like, are like $2,000. But still, this is a pretty expensive setup. So, you know, you talk about, you know, $700 versus $350. I think that this is a good tripod just if you're just starting out. Or for me, it's a good backup tripod. And it breaks down super small. It's easy to take with you, easy to travel with. So I do think it's worth it, you know, and I think they're on sale right now. And you know, if you can afford something like this, I definitely would pick it up. I do think it's pretty stable, you know, but like I said, you gotta have that tool. Don't use this. Don't be anywhere without this tool, because the legs do come loose and that is annoying. So I think that is gonna wrap it up. And you know, I hope this, if you're looking at buying this, I hope this video helps you out a little bit. But anyways, I'm gonna call it good there, and have a good day.